Hi guys.
Hi guys. How welcome back.
Yes.
A little dance. Real woman, real talk.
Let's go.
Let's go. That's right. You know what?
Subscribe. If you didn't subscribe yet, subscribe. We have more and more shows coming.
Yes. So thank you for liking as well. If you like the content, leave us a comment. If you have any question or even any suggestion, we always we like to hear from you.
And to hear, to know more, and to exchange with you guys.
Yeah.
Yes. You're so beautiful in green, Mama.
You look so good. You look like Mamacita.
See, I put my serious attire. Yeah. We're going to talk about career today.
Yes. It's a very important topic. Yes, I think for the well-being, we have to dive into that subject. We need to understand a little bit the concept of career, well-being, how to navigate in that huge sphere. Don't get me wrong. Minimum 40 hours a week we spend at work, thinking of work even more. And so it's very important in order to complete our transformation to understand how important the well-being and having a work balance, it is important, because it is. If you want to keep that transformation going and become the better person, well, I think you need to understand who you are as a person and what's your boundaries.
Yeah. And it's true that in our transformation, since we have only 6 months,
that's not much.
We tackle every... No, it's not so much, but at the same time, it's enough because we know what we need to work on. And this is one of the things. So how to have a better balanced life between personal and career.
Yeah.
So these are, we came up with a few facts, things that the behaviors we had impacts and different things that we want to bring up to you. So first of the thing was that guilt of not doing enough. So when I went in the workplace for the first time, I always felt like guilt. I was not doing enough. I was not doing enough. So I always tend to try to do more, like, oh, write me this. And then so I would write this for this. So I would write it for this and that, this and that. And like, always guilty, like always need to do more.
Yes.
It goes a lot with the mentality, since we weren't trained by the baby boomers. You're going to see our other capsules about the generations.
Yes.
Subscribe.
Maybe here.
So it makes sense, right? That we always feel guilty. And we always feel also the perception that to have to be successful, you need to kill yourself at work. This is such a bad perception and a bad idea that came from, I don't know where, the 90s, I don't know. But we start our professional journey in those mentalities. So for sure, we felt a lot of guilt of not doing enough.
Yeah.
And we had that perception that to succeed, we had to do more. So
to succeed, to become someone, the minimum wasn't enough. We are conditioned that more it's better versus now less it's more. It's crazy how the reality shift. So yes, you're absolutely right. Work.
Total opposite now. Like it's crazy how it has evolved so fast. It's crazy how the mentality have evolved so fast.
It's amazing. It's good.
It's amazing. That's why we love the millennials. Thank you, bro.
Honestly, you guys need to watch the other video. You're going to understand why we come up with this topic, because it's absolutely a must. But we're talking on the generational differences, and you're going to see why we love the millennials and how they help us evolve, I would say, quite dramatically.
We carry those beliefs. We do carry those beliefs in us where you need to work more, and if you want to succeed, you need to work day and night. So now we have this new knowledge of, no, you need to work less and work better. Use of your time, your use of your, when are you the most effective? What does your strength? We're becoming more intelligent, but just to put in context, when we started to work, we didn't know all that. So now we're sharing it. Be careful.
Yeah.
Not to carry that guilt of not doing enough.
Yeah.
Be careful not to carry that belief that if you want to succeed, you need to work. Yes, but to work effectively, you need to be healthy, you need to be happy, you need to be balanced. If you feel that's all the Google thing, you know, if you feel happy and okay, you'll perform and you'll succeed.
Exactly. And the work balance, I know that people might think that it's a lazy concept of the millennial, that work balance, it's because they're lazy and they want to enjoy life and spend their parents' money. Actually, that's absolutely false, because study have shown that actually someone who's more rested, someone who's less stressed, someone who's more happier as a person in their personal life will perform much better in the work field. So it's a correlation that it's very directly linked. Yeah. This is why a work balance, it's not a lazy concept. It's not a concept for people who don't want to work as much. Yep. Absolutely not. You can perform on a project better if you actually put that balance and your priorities at the right spot.
So it's based on all those old beliefs that it's logical when workaholism was celebrated, people working infinite hours were celebrated. So for sure, we went into the workforce with that guilt of not doing enough and that perception that if we don't die at work and like put like 100-hour week, we won't succeed. Yeah. So we came in with that energy, with managed by the boomers. So for sure, there was a lot of burnout, a lot of people that had a rough start of their career. That would be the end of their career. And they settled for like a more like a 9-to-5 or government job or something more.
That's so true.
Because it was rough. It was very rough.
Yeah.
And you see companies now, they have a better understanding. The purpose, let's be honest, companies, they always want to overwork you, right? They want to get the most out of you and it's totally okay. But now they have a better understanding of the human being. So they know, we thought about Google, right? Why did Google like create like a whole city where like it's a playground and you eat for free, you train for free.
Yeah.
They keep your kids for free, everything. So your job is no longer a job. It's a passion.
Yeah.
They have one day a week. They work on projects they want. They have their own organism inside where they create projects and innovations. Yeah. And so now your work, they understood that human beings to be as much as the most productive you can get people to be, it's to engage them in a passion and something they love in an environment where they're comfortable and they boom and they flourish. So we're all going. So that's why we love the millennials, let's be honest. They are the one with that spirit compared to the baby boomers and the X. They're the one with that spirit. I want to do what I love.
Yeah.
I was raised with, you can do things, try to do things you love, try to, right? Like you'll be like lucky, right? Our parents, they can do what they want to, you know, they find a way to make money. They stuck with it and they hustled, they milked the cow, right?
Exactly. And you enjoy your life on weekends and that's the only thing. And if you don't like your job, it's part of life. Life, it's hard. You're not supposed to like your job. It's supposed to be your paycheck. And you come and you're like, oh my God, I went to school. I was hoping I'm going to find that dream job. I'm going to be excited and I'm going to work with passion. But then I have my parents who say, you know what? It's not important. Just go find any type of job. You like it, you don't. Just work for it. Spend the rest of your life, because that's how.
Work hard. Work hard. It will be okay. Work harder. Do more.
Yeah. Do more. You're going to climb the ladder. You're going to become someone. And I'm like, okay, but that's not life. Like when you, and you knew, like there's a little voice who keeps saying, but that's not life. I want to work. And I had the pleasure to work in great company that I give my heart and I was passionate. I work hard, not because I was told to. Yes, some company, don't get me wrong, I had no choice because it was like a requirement. It was like an unwritten rule. But there's some other company that I did it because I loved it. And this is where you Google, that's what they understood. If you love what you do, and there's a quote, if you love what you do, it's not going to feel like work and you're going to wake up happy. My favorite day of the week when I work in that field was Monday. Okay, who can tell right now that their favorite day, it's Monday. I was excited for Monday. I couldn't wait for Monday because Monday was a new day and I was working on my project and I will be able to deliver something exciting. And I used to hate Fridays because, oh, that means I have to go home and I won't be able to.
I never went that deep.
Yes.
No, I never went that deep. But I
heard you say, yes, I know.
No, but I know because I feel you, like, because I'm a passionate person too. Everybody that knows me well at work should know one thing. I'm not working for anything else than passion. Like, I'm a very passionate person. Like, I do my work with passion, but this backfired because very, to give my all, it's been a long time. I understood I need to be passionate about what I do. I don't perform when I'm not, so I'm going to prove it. I know myself. I'm not consistent. When I don't like something, I'm like, ugh. No. So I went to do things I was passionate about. Mm-hmm. And with those beliefs of guilt of not doing enough and to succeed, I have to do more. Plus, like, the fire of a passionate person. Oh, my God, poor me. Like, the wall up.
Yeah.
And my big, like, I have big break hearts and heartaches that happened to me. And it's the third point we wanted to bring. It's like the expectations that you create.
Yeah.
You're making, you build that monster. And yes. You put that bar for your own self so high.
Yeah.
And you feel guilt of not doing enough. And you need to do more and more and more. And
yeah.
And you keep, and those expectations, like, everybody's like, wow, she's flying, like, she's walking on water. You heard that expression, right?
Of course.
But then it's heartbroken when you do all this, you have all this, and let's say you lose a parent. Relationship with work changed because that passionate place where you had, like, refuge and, like, so much joy and you gave your heart.
Yeah.
Isn't going to give you that compassion back. Isn't going to give you that passion back. So that's why we want to have that conversation to make that transformation for the next 6 months. Ask yourself a question. Where do you stand about your guilt about not doing enough?
That's a great question.
What is your perception? Yeah. Do you think that to succeed, you need to work day and night? Because if so, maybe you're mismanaging your own resources of energy.
Yeah.
Because that's not realistic. You have to take care of yourself. Be healthy. Work, balance, spend time with the people that are there to you.
Yeah, exercise.
Exercise, eat well, take the time to nourish your spirit with different things.
Yeah.
You become smarter, you know. It opens your eyes. Like, you cannot be creative and think outside the box if you always like this.
No, you can't.
So you have to open.
Yeah.
Life is a discovery, right? Work or not work, you know. Yeah. We're not slaves. You should enjoy life too. So
yes.
Be careful. Because companies, a lot of the time, you're going to give it your whole. Companies are heartless, sad to say, but they don't, it's for your manager to give back, right? And not the company. But most of the time, it happened to me so many times where I worked until 10 at night, 11 at night, midnight, 2, 3, 4 in the morning for companies that I was there at 9:10 in the morning, 9:10. I had to face an attitude. And these same company, they never paid me for extra time. They never paid me because I worked the whole weekend and I work all night. They didn't give me a bonus. They didn't say, hey, a million. Wow. Yeah. You blew us away. Sorry, we didn't give you everything you needed. And I saw you work like 12 hours a day. I'm so grateful. Take thank 10 you. Grand. It's a bonus for the great job. At least I can, thank you. No. Because don't forget, you're working for money. It's an exchange of service. We have a contract.
Yeah.
For this amount, I'm giving you 37 hours. If I decide to give you 47, my bad. I'm giving it to you. It's a gift from my heart because I'm generous and I love my job.
Yeah.
Right? But be careful because a lot of companies, they don't think the same.
No. And there's certain industry that I could think of that their philosophy, it's a given. Like, I'm giving you a paycheck per year. There's a reason why it's per year. And it's not even a question of not working at 1 a.m. or working at 10. I would say more the consulting firm. They're very harsh, very like 70, 80 hours. It's the minimum requested. I have a great friend of mine. She worked in a firm.
Yeah, but consultant, she's paid yearly?
She's paid like normal, like a paycheck, but like us, you know, our paycheck, it's not based on the hourly rate, but they say, okay, this is your salary for the year. So it's the same thing like us, but her, because
it's like agencies.
Yes, it's the same principle than agency. So those consulting firm, the big five, now you understand which one, it's, they expect you to work whenever they want. And they're going to call you at 10 o'clock. They're going to make you travel to Toronto. They're going to make you travel to Detroit within the same, almost the same days. But I get it's passionate. I understand that it's fun. But when it comes when it comes time that you get sick, I don't know, you get flu, whatever, they still expect you to perform as much as you perform the day before.
If you get sick, if you have a big hit in your life, The fact that you, I'm going to tell you something even deeper than that. The fact that you're working so much and you're not paid, you're losing money. I realized that.
Of course you do.
I lost money by always being counterproductive because you're so far away from your own life, always giving it everything to a company. So even financially, it's not even a good investment. Not to speak about the impact it can have on your health and on your psychological well-being and the quality of life you're building around you. So please be aware of those things. You're thinking of making the change with us. We are making the work. We are addressing our own beliefs and the way we interact with work. Also, it has to be fun. It has to be balanced. It has to be smart and tackle our strength. Sometimes it's as simple as knowing when you are more productive during the day.
Yes.
So I have the whole day. I'm not going to say, okay, I'm going to wake up at 9 and work 9 to 9. I'm going to do it.
No. And that's the beauty. Yeah.
Because now I know better. I know how to be productive and how to work better with, right?
And you have that opportunity. Now most of the company, and I actually have to embrace that, they allowed you to have a flexible hour work. And those company who understood the benefit, you know that personally, I'm much more creative and productive and at night. So between 7 to 1 o'clock a.m., I'm going to be like on fire. Like my brain, it's like, don't get me wrong. I'm still 7 till 5, 6. It's okay. But knowing myself, the best creation that I did in terms of creativity, it was those hours. So those companies actually give you that flexibility. You end up winning tremendously.
I'm so, and again, I know I've said it a few times, but again, just be conscious of, and companies too, change that. It's ugly when you have people that give their all and they treat you like you know, like family, and they invested and they love your company and your promise and everything. It's so sad that you don't have that closeness to understand, oh, they have a problem in their lives. Okay, for me, when I had people like they go through breakup, they lose their parents, they have a situation in the living place with the, I always try to be understanding in my management of those different things so I can keep my resources and just give them the support. Sometimes you're just going to give a slack to someone 1 or 2 weeks. They'll be like, you just watch them to make sure they don't drop the ball heavy on you, you know, make a little checkup. Okay. Take some things, like give that support.
Yeah.
The one thing that companies, they ask a lot more, but they don't give anything more.
No.
So that's, and it's something that I've learned from my own experience. If I can share that experience with some people that would prevent them to invest so much in companies that don't give back, and for companies to realize that you have to start to give back. You cannot keep asking for more and never be willing to give more, if not money, time, compassion, understanding, whatever, you know?
Yeah.
But for me, I realized that at one point, it's like, okay, I'm keep giving it my all, and all I get is a slap in the face.
Yeah, and that's harsh. It's very hard for anybody, actually, to, you give your energy, you give your time, you give your love. Because honestly, I think when you're passionate, you end up giving your love to the company and it becomes like a relationship. And at the end of the day, when you go through a hard time, I don't know, someone...
Bye-bye. Something's wrong with you.
Yeah.
Do you want to be here? Like,
yes.
You're not as if it's... Like, I don't feel you're really here.
Yeah, like, are you happy here? Like, and they kind of put the blame on you, but instead having an open discussion, who say, how are you? Everything's okay.
What's going on?
Yeah, what's like going you want to talk about it? Like that genuine conversation. And that being said, what I'm trying to bring you, if do your research before finding the company. If for you having a flexible work balance schedule, it's really important. Do not jump into a company knowing that they have still that in the box mentality. If you want to find something, I don't know, for you, it's important to bring your pet at work. I don't know. It could be.
Yes. Well,
look, prioritize companies that are going to allow you to bring the pet. A daycare, because you have your kids, you want to find a daycare. It's crazy because it's simple little details that are going to make your life a whole. You're going to be much happier as a person. And if you are much happier, everything's going to be just in a easier, positive more way.
Productive, more fruitful in everything you're gonna do. So it's a win-win situation. And please remember, when you give to a company, always be aware you can do it because you love it. I've done it so many times.
Yes, but
all over again. Yeah. Just don't let everything drop everything, because I'm telling you, most of the companies, they're not built to support you when you won't be able to perform as much as you were. It's sad, but it's true. So be selfish. Be selfish. Companies are selfish. And if you do more, please, at one point, don't document everything you do. Before falling, that's something that I've learned. Like, I should have documented way better the things I've done. If it's only the hours I put in, and little information that, like, it's a little work, but if you do that, so at least you can, before having a breakdown, you can have the information and, like, make that demand, right? I've noticed that I work always 45 hours a week, like it's been 6 months, and I always count, and this is what I'm doing, and this is my role, and this is the hour, something. So either you hire someone else, or just give me 20K more, you know, but you make those requests, because if you keep giving more and one day you make a change, take a chance, ask for more. Because if the company says no, then you know.
Well, you know what,
but if the company says yes, then you can say, oh, maybe I'm investing in the right place, because they hear me and they respect me and they trust me enough to believe my truth. I'm overworked.
Yeah.
I need more money, or I need help, whatever it is. Mm-hmm. But have those daring moments where you take charge and be conscious. So I'm just telling you what I would have loved someone to tell me in some particular moments in my career. So I'm just sharing with the world.
It's
because when you break down, then you don't value anything. You know, you're not worth anything. She's not, like, she's always like, something's wrong with her. I don't know. Like,
well, you don't want to get to that level that you break down. Because it's hard to get up. And we know that when you get to a burnout, it's something that it's going to stick. You're going to deal for the rest of your life. So
don't put yourself. They never got out of a burnout or depression that were like built up from a workplace. And they stay with them, and they kept all their lives. They're dysfunctional.
Yeah. So don't put yourself in that situation. Learn your boundaries. Learn how enough it's enough. Learn how to step back, take a step back, look at the global picture, look to love yourself enough to say it's enough. Learn to communicate. I know it's hard discussion, and it's not really easy to talk to even your manager. Like you said, listen, I realize I've been giving 60 hours or 45 hours, and the load of work continue. What can I do now? And
because I know the sorry, I'm cutting you off, but I just want to add to this, but because I know the ungrateful workplace, it's a good test. Because when you go to them with those, if you know it's true that you're giving your all, you're passionate, you're performing, you're excelling, but this always requires for you to work 10 or 15 or 20 hours a week, that's not normal first. They should see it by themselves and offer you more. They're not documented. And put like an honest observation of, as a manager, that's my job to understand that this role is not well balanced, right? Mm-hmm. So, but I'm just saying this because if the answer you have, it's like, oh, wow, I didn't know this. Okay, maybe I give you a, like, sometimes they're going to buy you, right? Okay. Like, money. Mm-hmm. If it's too big, they're going to give maybe another responsibility. But if they tell you, yeah, but I feel like maybe you're not managing your time properly. I noticed that you talk a lot and da-da-da.
Yeah.
So now you're going to see while you're bleeding yourself, judgment. So you're giving and they're judging you. Yeah. They're not grateful.
They don't have your best interests, put it that way.
No. So these are little things you can do that are good for you, and also you can understand the environment and the people you're around and where you're investing your precious time and talent. So this is something from my millennials. Know your worth.
Yes.
And if they don't like it, take it somewhere else. So the HR philosophy, you know, we spoke about it, it's all aligned with everything we just say. Now companies, they know, they say that beautiful sentence, and I can't wait for the moment when it's going to be actually true.
Yeah.
But the company is that it's not the employees are not working for the company. Basically, it's your manager, is the company is working for you to help you to be able to give the best of yourself, right? So as a manager, my team is not working for me. I'm working for my team, making sure they have everything they need. They have the right support, the right tools, the knowledge, everything they need to perform, right? I have a designer. It's always a problem. Okay, do you have a good photo stock? Do you have good pictures? What's going on? Okay, do you have enough time? Other briefs are not well prepared. So everything as a manager, as a director, as a VP, as a CEO, it goes like this, right? So the CEO is supporting his VPs to get what they need to do their job and have that vision, right?
Yeah.
And the same thing, the directors, the VPs are giving them like the big information so they can direct their teams. So it's another philosophy versus the CEO wants something, he tell the VP tell the director tell, and then we just do and what are we doing this? We should go there and they keep going there. And it's one way, right?
Yeah, bottom up. But what I realized, the companies are smart. And don't get me wrong, those CEO, the all those beautiful people on the top, they understood that working that way generate this. When you start to understand that a happy employee would generate a lot of revenue because naturally he's going to work harder, he's going to be more passionate, he's going to offer his time without being forced. Now you understand the... You understand the value of employee experience. I would say 15 years ago, we're talking a lot about customer experience. Oh, we need to create experience for a customer. It's super important, the experience that they're going to have with their company. So that was like a trend word, company experience, customer experience, customer. But the thing is, when you get back two steps and you look, okay, well, customer experience has to go with employee experience, employee engagement, then naturally if you offer the tools, the training, the office area, the flexibility, all the stuff that they need for those employees to actually function and deliver projects or deliver a service to your customer, the customer experience and the customer engagement will come naturally because that's how they're programmed. If you operate through a space of fear, a space of authority, when you're going to have your frontline employees going to deal with your customer, that energy will be felt. The people actually with your survey, they will know, they will feel like something's wrong with that company. Something's wrong.
And of course,
the customer feels that.
A lot of time, like the companies that have very bad, I'm in marketing, and a lot of time when companies have bad reputation, they have a very unhealthy internal philosophy also.
Yes.
It's
they don't value the human.
And you never can expect people to carry your vision and carry your company, and you mistreat them.
Yeah.
You mistreat them and you want them to carry the message. For sure, the message goes like,
exactly.
You're going to like beat them in the head and then, hi, hi. No. They're going to beat in the head your clients. Yes. Makes me think of Bell Canada. Sorry, Bell, but
that's funny.
Wrong in there. I don't know what's wrong, but something's wrong.
But you know what? It's crazy because companies, those one actually who didn't understand the transformation come through the internal, through ourself, our family circle, in order to deliver a great engagement to the customer. If you actually think for a second, your employee are your best ambassador. You should invest in them. You have, I don't know, a company of 1,000 employees who works. If you invest in their experience, imagine the spread of the word could be on social media, on word to mouth. They are your best ambassador.
I totally agree with that, but I would say that this is so, like, it's like an advantage in the sense that even if to take this out, like, let's say they're not ambassadors, they don't talk about your company, just let's talk about the company, the functioning company that you have. Mm-hmm. You know, you cannot have a functioning company if the people who are carrying whatever they're carrying are mistreated because they won't perform. So your company won't perform. So if you mistreat your employees, they won't perform as much as they could. And extra on the cake and the cherry, they could actually leave your company and say, it's such a beautiful company.
Yeah.
I love it, WorkyCare. Hey, do you know this company? No, it's not true. I work there and I love that company. It's a good company. This is extra, extra, extra. But for the, I say that for the cynical, right? That they will say like, ambassadors, whatever. No, okay, but cynical, fine. But even just the functioning, like well of functioning, you cannot have performing result growth with employees that you mistreat. I'm sorry.
Yeah. And you're going to see employees who are the most like really happy and they love what they work. I'm going to see their posts on Facebook. I'm going to see some sharing from Instagram. I'm going to see LinkedIn posts saying, oh, look, and they're proud. When your employee is proud to work for you, that means a lot. So don't lose that momentum and use it as a fire in order to create that culture aspect. We talk about culture, transformation culture, but at the end of the day, it's not complicated. Just put the human at the center of your decision and there's a huge step done. If you put the human, que ce soit, if you put the human, the employee, the customer, or your partner, or anybody at the center of your decision will follow in the right way. If you start to put this, the money aspect, the greediness, or any other decision, your company will not follow.
And but a lot of companies, they do it with the clients.
Yes.
And that's a mistake that you all focusing on the experience we're giving to the client, but totally, like, I don't know how you can disregard the fact that the service we were talking about will be provided by people that are mistreated.
Yes.
So anyways, I know I've been repeating that for a long time, like for a few times, but like, I mean, it's so, for me, it's so like, duh!
Well, it's logical.
It. Yeah, it's so logical, but they keep doing it in companies. Yeah. A lot of companies, they invest so much in telling clients this and that. Keep your money, build like an amazing workplace for already growth, stability, engagement. So you won't have always to someone come, someone leave, someone come, someone leave. So nothing like, so there's no growth, there's no expertise, there's no value building in the people running your company. So you're being run by newbies all the time, but you don't want newbies at one point, right? You're in a company,
you want to have a great balance.
So you cannot keep your employees, so your growth and your performance and your speed will always be like why, because you're not building on strong foundations.
No
So for you guys, sorry we went for the company like what to do, but for you guys, it's still,
don't get me wrong, I'm still, as a business owner, I want to make as much as money as possible, but I want to use this in order to make. And if I can use the engagement, the happiness, and use the human emotion in order to generate this, I am the first one who do it. I'll do it just in order to increase that 500%, 600%. But you can use, actually, stop believe that you cannot use emotion and well-being and happiness to achieve your goals. It's okay that your employees are laughing. It's okay that your employees are happy. Yeah. And it's okay that they don't feel they're at work. You don't want your company, your employee to feel they're working. You want to feel them that they contribute for something greater they are.
Yeah, I'm so in with you on that. That a lot of things, because of those beliefs of guilt of not doing enough and have to kill yourself at work, then if you're at work and you're having fun and they're too much like, oh, it's not serious, they're not really working seriously. Yeah. Like they're not. So there's something like suspicious about like having fun and then at work when it should be the core of like the vibe at work, right? Having fun, exploring, innovation, curiosity. So everybody open. And a lot of times, So all this to say that we're going, like the HR are going there, the Google, we see that going. Yeah. So then again, thanks to the millennials, and we're happy to like to that experience that is in the middle of everything, the client's experience, then the employee's experience, then it's the life experience. I think this is where we are.
Yes.
But it's true, everything goes together. So you can be yourself at work. You can be provided an environment when you can be yourself. You know, like you can work and perform in conditions that are respectful of yourself. And they are aligned with your personal goals also.
Yeah. And I would put it furthermore, client experience, I would change it with engagement. the experience with engagement. Because now that you, when you look back, it's like you could have a great experience, yes, but if you're engaged, we achieve.
Yeah, greatness. That's the core. Yeah. But in marketing, that's a lot of what we do. Like when we do events and activations with brand.
Yeah.
Like a lot. All we're trying to do is to engage, right? So yes. If me, I'm like a million ways ink, and in a hot winter event, I give you like hot chocolate. It has nothing to do with what I do, but you'll be like, oh, Valentina in a million ways. It's so warm and sweet.
Yeah.
Right. This is it's an imagined way to like, that's how you engage.
Yeah.
You live something, you share something with someone that gives them emotions, and that emotion and that feeling they feel, this is how you want them to feel about your company. Your brand. So that's what the core of engaging is. So it's the same thing for your employees. So if you read the mission, you know, first day they give you all the thing and it's amazing. They have such a good like culture and balance. And then where the gym is? Gym, is there a gym included? Oh yeah, it's in the basement.
They're gonna say you're allowed to have $20 off on your membership, but by the way, you can't leave during the lunchtime because we don't expect you to go have lunch. So your gym, well, you're gonna have it to find it between when you come home and your weekend. So it's like, it's not really aligned.
Yeah, there's no perfect world. It's something that you have to manage and deal with and get the most out of it. So balance at work, be careful of your files, the ideas, mentality you carrying with you. Mm-hmm. They might not serve you. You don't need to die at work to be performing. You can work. Just know yourself, listen to yourself, take care of yourself. It's a machine, right? You take care of it so it functions better.
Be yourself.
Be careful. Sometimes you might give your all for companies and they won't give you back. Don't give back. So get paid at least.
Yeah, you know what? Be conscious and do something. Go get something else and
find something else. Ask for more, whatever. But just don't say I've done it. And rarely. So we talked about. We talked about the whole type of management. You know. The scarcity and but we talked about it in our other generation video, so I think we've been through it, but for sure we're trying to prevent all those type of management dysfunction.
Exactly. I think the main message of the video, it's work balance, it's super important. If you do something, be aware what you're doing. If you make a decision to do more, be conscious about it. Do your research about your values, the company's values, in order to bring your own happiness and that balance. If for you working 70 hours a week but having a big paycheck, it's important, go for it. Go for that big company and work whatever. But if you know that you want to spend some time with your family, with your friends, do your research. Go to the companies that can actually are suitable for your needs. Try to find companies that actually embrace the person that you are. And I'm sorry, but there's industry that are very stiff in their way of thinking. And if you're a super creative, bubbly person, and you know that you're going to come as an alien in that place, I can guarantee you won't be happy. I can promise you, you'll be constantly with your own demons and say, I don't fit there. And you're going to start to blame yourself. Say, oh, something's wrong with me.
Yeah, but you don't have to. You can work in environments where you don't fit and fit in by knowing your value, knowing your... what is important to you, knowing your expertise. And so I find it's delicate to say that, because for me, I don't fit anywhere. That's why I would say that. I don't fit anywhere. Okay, so that's why I'm cutting you off, you know? So I don't want anyone like me that doesn't fit anywhere to limit yourself. Like I worked at the airport, for example. I don't fit in the airport. Like I'm nothing about security. I'm crazy. I told them at the hiring day, I was like, are you sure? Like, you know, I'm a bit crazy, right? But it's okay. But it has to be within the right set of goals, right? Because I told them who I am, what they wanted, what I wanted.
But
because I had that maturity. But when I was younger, for sure, I would have been like, ding, like, like uncomfortable, and so it goes with the stage of your career.
It goes in your stage, and don't forget the marketing at the airport. They did a huge mental transformation. They were ready for a girl like you to come and
blow their mind away. It's my manager that was amazing, and that had she was not close to someone with my personality, because she's someone who has a big personality too.
So that's why she went for you.
More than the company. It's the person that chose me. She had that spark too. So she took me in. Yeah. But that's really more her than the company. I don't think, like, I have a great relationship with the airport, but I don't think I'm still like a regular fit for the airport. And it was amazing. Like, it went well, right?
Yeah.
So that's why sometimes you can be that little, but you have to be conscious of the environment you are. Like, I know you come from financial and it's very harsh and everything, but it's good so you understand, right? And especially at the beginning of your career, I'm just going to say, if you want to work 70 hours and you're happy, like you're close to making that first six figures, you're like, yeah, I'm making it. Man, go with it. It's amazing, you know, because it's the start, you're learning, you travel. I've done it, Toronto, Montreal, travel, being on... You know, it's so fulfilling. But at one point, you have to understand, negotiate your money, take care of your finance, take care of what you're eating, your training habits. And if in any way your work threat the balance of those things, you have to be active about it, right? Yeah. So you don't end up at the end losing. You end up broke, fat, and unappreciated.
Try to have always a project on the side. I think that if you have a personal project that passionate you on the side, other than your company, it could be only just being crazy about fitness, being a completely foodie, having a blog, having something that you create. And it brings, I found that I had it. I had something that I had on the side that was... If my work wasn't going perfectly fine, I could come home and turn to this that represent me and suit me and make me go crazy about it. So when you have, for me, it's a great balance between who you are as a, I would say your side, other side that people don't see, that crazy side, and you have your professional side that if something goes bad, you still have a plan B.
Yeah, and also it keeps you forced to be balanced, because you keep room for different things in your life. And most of the time when it comes to burnouts and depression and stuff like that, it's because you lose all those links into your life. So you lose your friends, you have bad relationship with your family, you have no hobbies. So your work, it's everything.
Yeah.
So most of it starts like that, right? You drop passions and stuff. So keep a rich, healthy, diversified life.
Yeah.
And if you want to go for the workaholic for a moment of time, fine, but do it with respect for yourself and for your time. And don't expect companies to be like, no. You do it for you. So just be aligned with what you want.
Yeah.
That's what I can give you, like, after all those years of experience about the balance at work. For me, what was still but it's the conversation we had with you that helped me understand my own self.
Which one?
Because I was a bit of a workaholic. I was like, what's wrong with me and work? And because I'm passionate, and also like the baby boomers, like I worked with, they were so demanding. I was like in the mental state where I was like Supergirl.
Life is beautiful. Life is good.
No, it's true. Like, it's true. I can feel it in my heart, because I've been through those things. Like, I worked one day like six months, 12 hours, weekends time.
Yeah.
So at the end, like, I was like, just, I can't wait to take my vacation. I'm dying.
Yeah.
And it was like, okay, now we want this. Do you really want to be here? I'm like, what?
I know.
So I can't imagine someone having that, to tell you that. So that's why we're telling you that people... Millennials, youngsters, Gen X people, put yourself first.
Yeah, prioritize yourself.
Yeah, put yourself first.
We love you. Enjoy. Have fun. Subscribe.
Conversation.
Like. And give us a comment. Give us something crazy that happened at work. I want to hear you guys. And how you realize that work balance, it was important for you. We all had that moment, that slap in the face. And... And then you're like, it hurts. Let me go back. Exactly. Have fun.
Love you guys. Subscribe. Bye. Ciao.